Welcome back. Today, we'll be talking about getting data into the Common Data Service. Now, one of the key values of the Common Data Service you heard about earlier is we do the heavy lifting to get your data into one place so you can focus on building apps, finding insights, and automating your business processes. In this video, we're going to talk about how we make it very, very easy to bring your data together in the CDS. If you're already a customer today of Dynamics 365, you're having to do custom implementations, infrastructure, and code to stitch together information from across Dynamics 365 sales and operations. The Data Integrator feature of the Common Data Service does this heavy lifting for you. Today, we're focusing on Dynamics 365 data first, and soon we'll add support for third-party data sources, as well as Office 365 and Azure AD. Let's go take a look at how this works. We start in the Maker portal. Data integration is based off of what we call projects, and projects need connections. That tells you where data comes from. First, you'll create the connections for the data sources you want to use. I'm going to find my Dynamics 365 and Dynamics 365 for operations connections, create those. And now I'm going to add my Dynamics 365 for operations connection. Now, as you can see, both my Dynamics 365 for sales and Dynamics 365 for operations connections are created. I'll now switch over to the Administrator Center. Data integration projects are a way for us to group mappings of how data should move from a connection into the Common Data Service or from the Common Data Service out to a connection. We've pre-populated a set of templates. Think of templates as a way for you to quickly specify the configuration of what data you want to flow in or out. I'm going to create and instantiate the prospect to cache template, the first of these scenarios we've enabled. As soon as I've selected that, you can see below, it asks you to specify which connection we should use to pull information in from sales and which environment in sales. All of this functionality is built on top of the Common Data Service. And so you do need to tell us which environment you want to run the data integration project. Finally, we need to know what outbound connection, in this case, a Dynamics 365 for operations instance, and you can see I have quite a few, and a company code. We need to know where to put that business data in Dynamics 365 for operations. At the end of this, I'll click Next. Notice, the Common Data Service is acting as the conduit for data to move from one service to another. So we're simply telling you this. You click OK, and the sync job will begin. Now, we actually have a significant amount of data being moved back and forth, so I'm going to flip over to an instance that's already been created and run. In this case, I'd previously created the demo prospect to cache data integration project. When I open this up, it will tell you what the different tasks are. These are what compose the actual project, as well as an execution history of what has previously run. As you can see, the various legs of this project have run before. Moving data from the sales instance into the Common Data Service, and moving data from the Common Data Service into the operations instance. All of this is previously run, and you can see, in this case, that that data is populated inside the Common Data Service. So Prospect to Cache is just the first example of the templates we'll be shipping out of the box. In the coming months, you can expect to see many more of these to pull in entities from the Dynamics 365 family, as well as your own data sources. Thanks.